Well, you guys, we're on the last verse in Colossians chapter 3, which is verse 25, and then we're also going to go over to verse 1 of chapter 4. Colossians 3:25, "For the wrongdoer will be paid back for the wrong he has done, and there is no partiality." And so every person will be responsible for their sin. God doesn't show partiality in the sense that he doesn't judge one person differently, that the consequences of sin will remain. Obviously, the punishment of sin, Christ is born for the believer, not the unbeliever. But ultimately, God is just, and he must punish sin. There's a scripture in, in 2 Corinthians, just regarding... No, Romans 12, verse 19, "Never take your own revenge, beloved, but leave room for the wrath of God. For it is written, 'Vengeance is mine, I'll repay,' says the Lord." And so we mustn't take vengeance, we mustn't repay evil. We allow God to judge the sinner, and he will take revenge. So we don't have to worry about when people sin. And so as we look at that in the context of how slaves and masters must react to each other. The law must still take its root, but we don't go and take the law into our own hands. And so let's go over to verse 1 of chapter 4. "Masters, treat your bond servants justly and fairly, knowing that you also have a master in heaven." And so masters mustn't take the law into their own hands. They must be fair, they must be just. That word fair is equality or similar to partiality. And so if a slave or an employee is due a certain amount, master mustn't withhold money. He must be fair. He must pay that person according to what he needs to get. In 1 Timothy 5:18 it says, "The laborer is worthy of his wages." And that word justice is sometimes translated as righteousness. He must be just with his dealings with the servant or with the employee. And so that justice and fairness is very much the two qualities that the master must have. And like the slave, the master is doing it in the presence of the Lord. The slave says he does everything as unto the Lord. And so the slave is working hard as if Jesus is there with him, and even when the master's not there, he's not only working hard when the master's looking. And in the same way, God is looking at the master and saying, "Are you being fair? Are you being just?" Because it says there, knowing that you also have a master in heaven, knowing that God is above you and judging you for your actions, the master must be fair and right in all his dealings in the workplace. And I think we'll just leave it there for this morning. Amen.